Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jackie and today I am here to do a non-spoiler review of Stay Sweet by Siobhan Vivian. This was the chapter by chapter book club book of the month for the month of May, which is the book club I run over on Goodreads. If you guys do not know, the link is down below. This was our May pick, and this is a YA contemporary novel that follows our main character Amelia, who has been going to this local ice cream stand since she was a little kid. And this ice cream stand in particular has been a big hit in her town since its founding in the 1940s, and she's also has been working there for the past 4 years. And during her senior year of high school, she is named head girl of the stand, which pretty much means she is the manager of it. And she shows up for her first day of work to be head girl, and she finds the owner of the stand dead. And pretty much it goes on a downward spiral from there. The grandnephew of the owner shows up to take over the stand, and this stand has been run by females ever since its founding, so this is a big adjustment for the workers to get used to, and the grandnephew is also threatening to take away all the values that the workers over the years have held near and dear to their hearts. And again, that's a huge change for the workers. So that is a brief synopsis. Like this, I said at the beginning of this video, it will be a non-spoiler review, so if you guys have not picked up this book, I will not spoil anything. So, kind of a brief overview of my thoughts. I did not like this book. I actually ended up DNFing this book at page 248, which is a little over halfway through. It just was not for me. And now let's get into why. So, the first thing I'm going to talk about is the writing style. I think Siobhan Vivian has a pretty good writing style. It's just very flowery and, you know, very summery, perfect for the summer time read. My biggest pet peeve for this particular book, however, was that it was written in the second person point of view, which is one of my biggest pet peeves in books, is when they're written in second person. I cannot stand it. It makes it not feel like a novel and makes it feel like an instruction manual or a textbook. It drove me insane. But other than that, I think the author's writing style is really nice. This was my first book that I have ever read by her, so I think I will check out future books by her. I think her writing style overall is pretty nice. Jumping into the characters again were pretty good. I liked them. I think Amelia was very relatable, and I liked her. She reminded me a lot of myself during my senior year of high school. I also like the side characters, like, for example, we have her best friend, Kate, who also kind of reminded me of myself in a way, so always fun. And then we have Grady, who is the grandnephew of the owner, who was supposed to be unlikable, so I didn't like him at all, to be honest. I mean, there were certain points in the book where you were supposed to like him, but overall, he was kind of just meh. And I didn't really like him. Then going into the romance. Oh gosh, the romance. This romance in this book between Amelia and Grady was not good. I did not like them together. I mean, you kind of know from the moment Grady is introduced that they're going to end up together, so it's not really a spoiler, but no, I didn't like it. The minute that they officially got together is when I pretty much DNF'd the book. I was like, I don't want those characters together. I don't like Grady at all. No. So if you guys couldn't tell, I did not like the romance. Then diving into the plot, which there really wasn't a plot because of the point of view in which it was written, that really took away from any sort of plot that was there. It was non-existent, and if there was any plot, it was very predictable. You kind of know from like 50 pages in what's gonna happen. So yeah, not a very good plot in my opinion. And then finally, let's talk about diversity. There wasn't really any diversity that I could really tell. There was no character that was really identified as any different other race besides white, or no LGBTQ+ characters that were a main character that really came forth, at least in the 248 pages that I read of this book. That could have changed in the latter half of the book. Again, I don't know. I DNF'd it, so not a whole ton of diversity. So if you're looking for a contemporary with a lot of diversity, this probably wouldn't be the one. Overall, Like I said, I didn't like this book. I think if it had been written in maybe first or third person point of view, it would have been a lot better. And if the characters had been a little bit more developed, I think it would have been fine. And I can definitely see why people would really like this book. It definitely has some appealing aspects to it, but it wasn't for me, and I ended up giving this a 2 out of 5 stars. So that is my entire review for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to give a big thumbs up and subscribe if you have not already. I post new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below if you guys have read Stacey and what you thought of it, as I would love to know. And as always, all my social media links are linked down below for you guys who would like to follow me on any of those. And with that being said, I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day, and I will see you soon for another video. Thanks for watching today. Bye!